I'm Monica, I'm 37 years old, and I have a birthmark growing on the side of my face. My birthmark starts above my eyebrows and along the side of my left side of my face and down my neck.
These above my eyes, they itch so much, and they're rough, and they're like flaky skin. And then these on my cheek, they're not so bad, but they itch still too.
The ones above my eyebrows, they itch the most and bother me the most. You know, it's like if you were to have a scab on your skin, it eventually starts itching, and it's the same effect. And if I scratch it, it'll bleed. See, it just itched, and then I rubbed it, and it just started bleeding on me. My birthmark has restricted me from being outside for long periods of time in the summer because the heat bothers my face. I've always had this birthmark my whole life. The medical term for it is nevus sebaceous, is what I've always been told. It was started really small, probably it was about the size of my index finger. I was bullied as a kid. You know, people telling me I look like I had a pepperoni pizza face. Once I've reached puberty, it got worse. And that's basically why I had many surgeries back then, because I was made fun of quite often. I've had plastic surgery, dermabrasion surgery, laser surgery, but it's always come back. It's frustrating. I haven't had any surgery or had anything done since I was 25 years old, and I'm 37 now. I gave up. Just live with it. And so that's basically what I've been doing. Working at the movie theater, it's not my dream job. I got my degree in early childhood development, but then when I started doing my student teaching, the person interviewing me happened to say, we don't think we can hire you because based on your appearance, we don't think the children will accept you.
Ready for sweet corn?
Yes.
I like to come here to my parents' house. We have a great relationship, and they are supportive in everything I've done.
I know that you've been insulted forever, but I don't think you can do anything more than be who you are. Monica is a cheerful person, but she's had to endure a lot of hardship because of the birthmarks on her face.
Dr. Lee is my last hope and my last lifeline to basically get anything done. I just feel like she knows a lot more than anybody I've gone to. To finally be in California, and I'm excited to meet Dr. Lee.
Let me just take your temp.
I hope that she can remove it all at once. It would make myself be more confident, and hopefully nobody will say anything anymore. No being bullied or made fun of. Try to get things accomplished.
You in person.
I'm gonna take my mask off, and you can too, because we're outside and we're 6 feet distanced. Tell me a little bit about what you have here and what brought you here.
Well, ever since I was born, I was called nevus sebaceous, what I've been told.
Right. So let me tell you a little bit about nevus sebaceous, and let's see if this matches up with you. You're born with it, like a birthmark. When you're young, before you go through adolescence, it's more smooth. And then as you get older, it gets bumpier, more like warty.
Yeah.
Is that kind of what you smell? It sounds
so that's probably what I have done. I've had dermabrasion, laser, and plastic surgery.
Okay.
It almost grew back immediately.
Yeah, yes. It continues to evolve.
Nevus sebaceous can grow and tends to evolve as we age, especially during puberty. So it's not unusual that Monica has had treatments and she still continues to have issues with this. But it's been really disheartening and frustrating for Monica. She has this extensive growth that she was born with. It's congenital. A lot of things happen in the womb when we are developing as a fetus, and we all develop moles. Normally, we have them scattered, a few around our body, some people more than others. She's one that has been born with thousands of moles in one specific area. I really need to examine this condition up close and see whether I can perform any surgery on her.
Well, this is just like little focal little areas, but they come up like little warts. I can see why dermabrasion and even laser might not be fully effective because it's harder to penetrate something that's really thick. It would be nice to try to shave some of this down and as much as you tolerate. So I'm gonna use an electrosurgery tool. It'll cut it off, but it'll also cauterize it at the same time. Okay. So we'll try to make it all nice and flat.
I have not had that done.
Yeah, so hey, let's try something new.
Yay. She says she's gonna try a whole different procedure on me that I've never had before. I'm excited. I'm ready to go. Is it time yet? Can I get this done? Now.
Let's try it. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and tell my girls to set us all up and we'll bring you back in just a minute. I'm gonna make sure you're nice and comfortable and numb, okay?
Okay,
all right.
Sounds good.
I'll see you in a little bit.
All right, bye.
A lot of what bothers her is what's raised up on the surface of the skin, so I can try to get as much of this as flat as I can. I'm using different techniques this time compared to previous procedures that Monica's had. Some of us are more comfortable using a laser. Some of us are more comfortable using cold, hard steel. But they're all essentially trying to get to the same final conclusion. We're trying to really debulk and get rid of some of those raised areas. The risks are bleeding, infection, discomfort, more scarring. And so that's what we have to ascertain. Is this going to look better than what she had before? Because that's really what we're trying to do. We're trying to make her feel better about her skin.
Yeah, I feel like I'm done. Like, I've been through enough pain right now.
You have been, I know.
And you've got it down the tough spots that I've had problems with.
Okay, take a look with the mirror. I know you're swollen, but you know those little warty ones are gone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see an improvement.
It does look better than it did, but I know it's never going to be perfect for you.
It looks good. It looks better than it did. I'm really excited to see the progress, and hopefully they won't come back.
Hopefully I get to see you
again.
Yeah,
because I would like to do more, but you know, I just want to take it in spurts so that I'm...
Yes, of course, and I actually think it looks good.
She worked with me. Like, any point that I felt like I was feeling any pain or whatever, she took a break. It's not gonna be one surgery and everything's gonna be gone. It's gonna be probably several surgeries. It just happens to do with how much pain I can tolerate.
I adore you and your charmer. I'll be talking to you.
Thank you. I see that there's improvements, but I just felt like I had enough pain for the day. I felt there was time for me to take a break. Maybe I'd give it a month for everything to heal and hopefully come back later.